agave seminar he did here. I love this stuff, and it's quick ways to honey hole and just quick ways to get access while I'll be standing. Obviously, anyone standing, he's probably going to try to get inside position, or I'm going to try to get inside position. Here, let's scoot over here. So, it doesn't matter. If I want to initiate first, obviously, I'm going to be trying to get shin to shin on the lead leg. Once I connect my shin to shin, I want to get a deep five-finger Jew claw over the under the knee, right around. I want to see my fingers on the other side. Because now when I rev my elbow down to attach it into my knee, see what happens? I have this nice mechanism that makes him get heavy. Without even putting my body weight behind it, just me pushing my knee, flexing my arm, boom! That's pushing pressure into this knee, making him have to take a step. What I'm going to do first, just to get warmed up, is now I'm going to put my body weight into it, but what I don't want to do is this. I don't want to fall down. This is dangerous. This is dead. Yeah, exactly. I want to keep strong, stiff, and my body's going to go with the momentum of my hand. Boom! That makes him take that step. I know he's going to take that little inch step. As he's going to take that step, my hand's chopping, and I almost want to karate chop the mat under his heel. At the same time, I'm putting my forehead into the inside of his knee. That's going to turn the knee out, compromise his balance. He's going down. When he goes down, I'm lifting. I'm stepping into my inside position. Now, all I'm going to do here, I'm going to get a deep five-finger grip on the heel. I'm pulling it, and I'm kind of sucking my belly out and putting it back in. And now when I land, look where I'm stapling. Inside staple on the thigh, heavy chest on top leg, elbow comes into my knee. This shuts his guard down. He's facing away from me, his hips are pinned, he's completely offenseless right now. He's got zero offense, he's gonna have to start thinking defense first before offense, and that's my favorite. When I know I'm not in any dangerous position yet, I get to think a little easier. See what I'm saying? So again, when I land on the staple, arm comes over and I close this. This leaves a little circle, this cuts him off. Now from here, I can start hand fighting, MMA, I can do damage, and I got a lot of different options here, okay? And that's just the warm up. Again, if he initiates the inside position, go ahead. I just gotta pummel in. And now I'm going shin to shin. Again, my body goes with the pull. I catch, I'm driving the forehead. I lift up, I step in. Again, from here, the opposite hand comes over. I suck out, pull, dropping down, heavy chest, everything, ready to go. Make sense? Mm-hmm. So I get my shin to shin, I get my elbow position. Again, it starts with a strong arm and the knee push. Yeah, you don't even have to give it to me. Again, the harder I do it, the more he's gonna push, right? And then if I put my body weight into it, boom, I know that I'm gonna be successful. I don't wanna be too tilted, I want my posture up, because again, it's gonna be a technical stand-up right from here. I'm just coming right up, right? And boom, dropping down, ready to go. Again, MMA, I'm loving it here all day, you know? Jiu-Jitsu, I'm not gonna hang out here, I'm gonna move or wait to see what he's gonna try to do to set up my next move. Let's say he starts playing heavy. I go to make a move and it's not there, or exactly, he starts posting off the head, it's not gonna be there. So what I'm gonna do, since he's heavy on that step, again, boom, since he's heavy here, this is light. I'm gonna elevate, and now I'm gonna pop it right into the armpit, okay? When I get it, I don't want it all the way up into the armpit, but I wanna be able to have my elbow pinched down on it, because this is gonna give me the control I need for when I take him elsewhere. Now from here, I'm just building a basic Ashi. I want to get my hips off the ground. This foot is one of my most important foots in Ashi grounding. I don't want to ever turn my toes in. Obviously, you're going to get lots of different stuff there. Corkscrewed, lens lock, all different types of toe holds, all different types of stuff. I'm going to make sure my heel is always going in. And the deeper I get my heel into his gut, the better. This, I like to describe this as like a side control frame from bottom. This helps me decide his pressure onto me. Yeah, exactly. I get to decide how close he gets, how far away he gets. And the deeper I get this, the harder it is for him to clear it off. If I get it right here on his hip bone, he's gonna push that off no problem at all. If I get it deep and now attach my wedge and close my wedge, it's gonna be a little fight. Okay, so I always try to build my frame first when I climb an Ashi and then close my knee. I wanna try to get this as deep as possible onto his belly button or better. And now we're here. The first thing we're gonna do, I'm just gonna do a basic Ashi takedown, okay? I'm gonna turn in and now I'm gonna turn out. Boom, bring him down. Notice I never post up on my elbow, I'm keeping everything pinched and shut. From here, all I wanna do, we're gonna practice coming straight up into Captain Morgan. There's another way I can use Captain Morgan, but I wanna use the momentum of the Ashi takedown. Right when we land, I'm gonna start posting onto this hand, and I'm gonna come up to Captain Morgan. Okay, it's called Captain Morgan, because obviously you're in like the Captain Morgan position. From here, we'll cut. Okay. If we're at a tournament, make contact, technical sit down, shift chin. I go to the takedown. It's not there, it's too far out of reach. I pop it up, build in my Ashi. Right when he starts to defend, I'm already turning, bringing him down. Coming up in to Captain Morgan. In drilling, put your weight on your knee and then close your position to keep the wedge tight. In real life, my weight's gonna be more toward my shin. So my shin's on his hips and on his stuff, yeah. And I wanna keep this nice and tight, the elbow stays tight the whole time. There's a lot of different stuff here. Lose a finish just by pushing the toes down. And I'm just pushing toes down until I get my tap. There's toe holds, there's heel hooks, there's lots of different stuff here, okay? But we're just gonna stop here for now. And again, I wanna use the momentum of the sweep to come up. One other way, say it doesn't work out that way. Again, hey, we're sort of tournament, we clap, clap. I make contact, I sit down, shin to chin, I go, oh, it's not getting to me. I'm here, I turn in, turn up. Say I can't, the momentum gets stuffed somehow. The first thing he's gonna start doing is trying to fight hands. More than likely. I'm gonna use him fighting this top hand to pull me right up. He's pulling this hand toward him. It's gonna pull me right up into Captain Morgan every time. So again, we land. I couldn't come up with the momentum. I start, you know, knee grabbing knee. I bait him. I'll grab knee or I'll even grab his hand. Now he's pulling me in. I'm using that pull. I push up. I'm just bringing my foot in front of my knee. And now I'm coming up. Make sense?
Yeah.
And that's Captain. And then from Captain, a million different things you can do. Boom. Now again, I'm using the elbow pinch, right? If for some reason at any time I transition to here, that's fine, but make sure we're keeping a flat hand and my thumb staying close to the inner part of the calf, shin, whatever I have, okay? I don't want to get too deep here, because if I ever get in finishing position, I want to be right here so I can kill my space and then get to my belly. Again, I'm gonna turn, I go here. Now, when I teach this in the gym, we gotta be very careful, because this is where straight ankles get nasty, because we're not attacking the tibia and fibula. This straight ankle is gonna attack the knee. Okay, because I'm gonna do Captain Morgan, but I'm not gonna let go of this straight ankle lock I have here. This is gonna start making his knee bend in a 90 degree angle and then turn the way it does not turn, okay? So whether he starts hand fighting, I bait him to hand fight, whatever, or I come up with the momentum. I'm coming up to Captain, and now look here. Right here is where stuff starts getting fishy. Because his knee's at this 90 degree angle, and then when I come up to this leg, I have a lot of pressure. Now the more I start taking this foot counterclockwise, the easier it's gonna be to get this tap. Okay, he's obviously not just gonna stay there and take it, but again, the deeper I bring this knee in, the tighter it gets, and I'm almost putting all my weight on my shin, and now I'm just turning this knee this way. And it's already nasty, and the more I start going belly down with it, the more I'm gonna get a nasty bend on this knee. I can transition from here or I can go for my finish. Go nice and smooth and just feel it. It's not gonna be a high percentage, but it's gonna make him panic and get us to other positions. So again, I land an Ashi. Whether I land an Ashi with the elbow pinch and then I just stand my right hand in, or I've already been here when I land. I'm coming up, driving the knee in, I'm here. Now once I got this bend, I know I got him. I'm just thinking about taking the foot this way, taking my knee this way. Make sense?
Uh-huh.
All right. You need to see, are you good? And if I grab this, beautiful. That's fine too. It gives me double control. I'm here. I'm going to turn in, turn out. Whatever we do, come back up to Captain, right? And if I ever feel like I'm losing my Captain, I always just grab the knee and suck it in. This helps me just keep knee control the whole time. Now from here, we got a few different options, okay? The first option, we're going to go the traditional route. From here, this was something I got from Adlai Cleveland back in 2016. He did a seminar here, and he called it the Leg Lock Inception Seminar. You can go like around the world in a bunch of different positions. You can always fast forward or rewind as well. From here, I'm just trying to get my belly in front of the knee. My shin is going to slide around, and my whole body's just going to kind of rotate. I'm never going to lose this elbow position on this foot, though. It's going to land me in a perfect shotgun grip knee bar, okay? I got to loosen up on the core just a little bit to get my core around his knee. But again, watch my foot, it's just gonna slide. Now I'm here. Now from here, I'm just pulling the elbow back. And now I can either keep the knee pinch or I'd pull this out and suck in. From here, I'm gonna pinch out or pinch in depending on which way he's trying to roll. And all I have to do is I'm gonna think about holding a shotgun. And now after I fire the shotgun, this is my finishing grip, right here. My fist is up in a right angle position. And now I'm pumping down and hipping it. Okay, again, we rewind. Captain Morgan, I have it tight, I hug the knee line and pinch. I'm gonna go shotgun grip knee bar. I'm just turning around the body. I'm getting here. Again, I can suck in and curl. I can pinch wide. It's all about what he's gonna be doing with this foot. If I can, sometimes, if he starts kicking, I'm gonna grab chop, okay? Now from here, everything's the same. I'm holding the shotgun, I fire the shotgun, and I hip in. If I can get it down low, I'll catch it down low. If I have both feet accessible, I'm gonna catch it in a little foot knot. It all just depends. But if he starts pummeling off this, again, I'm gonna lift my hand in, pull it down, suck it through. Make sense?
Yeah.
There's a traditional way to do it too, if you prefer more traditional. Down, slide into my shin to shin. I get him to take that step, elevate, boom, deep Ashi. Turn, bring him down, right off the takedown, I'm coming up. Right from here, I can start turning. Okay, now I'm getting into my shot at knee bar. Whenever I'm ready to clear, whenever I know this is abandoned, or if I know I'm just going this rotation just to get the honey hole, I'm gonna abandon and I'm turning and I'm coming up. I gotta attack secondary leg, both hands secondary leg. I'm not worried about primary anymore until I get back into good position. Again, once I get secondary leg, I'm getting dew claw, five fingers over, each over the heel and over the knee. Now from here, I'm turning him this way. I'm pulling him to the opposite hip. We were on this hip for the knee bar. I'm pulling him this way and I'm crossing the secondary over the primary for the honey. When I come out, a lot of people show up here before. When we're on the opposite hip on double trouble or honey hole, when I cross this before I'm about to go Texas, whatever, I'm a big fan of just crossing the ankles and pinching the knees. I feel like I get a much tighter clamp here than I do here. I feel like there's some room here. I feel like his thigh, you can start slipping this bottom thigh out, the primary knee. It's gone, yeah. But when I go here, when I cross it, this little X pinch, and now I pinch the knees, go ahead and try to find that space. It's not there. I'm clamping my heels into my butt. I'm pulling him back into me instead of just being here. This is just kind of holding him stationary. This, see how it's pulling the bottom, the inside thread in? That's what I want to do. That's what I want to create. And then I'm pinching the knees together. From here, I got a lot of different options. First option we can go to, I'm just going to attack the secondary heel hook. There's not a huge hip pinch, but the wedge is on the bottom hip, so I can still make this happen. All I'm going to do, again, I'm going to think about elbowing my back pocket. Here, let me take this off. I'm going to think about elbowing through his primary to my back pocket. All that's gonna do is it's gonna put his heel right in the croak of my thumb. A heel fits perfectly right here, and if you can get thumbs up right here, this is how I was always taught to finish a heel hook. I wanna have thumbs up right here, and I wanna pinch his toes into my ribs as tight as I can. Right here, this is making everything nice and tight. I can start going one-handed finish, but from here, again, think thumbs up. And again, look right where my thumb is on this heel croak. It's like it's meant to go here. There's a lot of grip here. From here, with my thumb still being up, I'm gonna go five fingers down, and I'm gonna gable. Now I'm gonna think about pulling this thumb right to my chin while I'm clamping on everything nice and tight on the hip wedge. And now, as I'm pulling this thumb to my chin, I'm hipping in to his knees. Sound good? Yeah. Again. Say we start standing. I clap, slap, I make the next one. Give a shin to shin, I elevate. Deep leg first. Here's my captain. I don't even have to stop at captain. Off the momentum of coming up, I can start transitioning here. And again, if I want to fail right from the knee bar, I'm going to let go. Secondary control, falling to the opposite hip, and I'll get my cross pitch. Again, from here, it's all about elbow in my back pocket. This fits right into place now. From here again, I'm here, pulling this thumb up as I'm pinching these toes as tight as I can. That's all it is. Now from here, I just hip in if I need to. I get my inside claw, my elbow attaches to the knee, that gives me my setup, the position, I elevate, pump him right into an Ashi, I turn, I use the momentum of me falling to come up, whether I switch or I keep the captain as I go here. Oh no, wait, I know where we're going now, I'm sorry, we already went that way. Now, I can get to honey hole just by backstepping as well. How I'm going to do it is I'm going to start getting my center of my shin right on his hips, now I'm kicking this knee out and around, and I'm falling right into honey. Again, from here, I want a little cross-X pinch. If you go here, I mean, it's all about how deep the knee line is and how we're stacking his hips over his own. And you'll feel that. You'll feel if you got a real deep honey hole, I feel my own mass pulling his hips over himself. And then I can decide where I want to go on my pinch. Okay? But again,
hopefully we'll have time to
I'm in captain. Instead of going this route, I'm pushing back onto him. I'm donkey kicking out, and I have to scoop my knee. And that's gonna give me my deep pinch, and I never had to let go, and I land immediately across double truck. Make sense?
Yeah.
From here again, I'll pull the knee in tight, elbow in my back pocket, I got it. Thumbs up right on the heel, I know I got it every time. I could one arm finish this if I really wanted to. But again, I'm gonna gable grip, pull it, and hip in. When he goes to pull out, this time, we're gonna do a modified grip. I'm gonna catch the heel with my forearm as he pulled out. I'm gonna pull it into my armpit, and now I'm gonna elbow the toes. From here, this is gonna come up, and I'm gonna grip my top forearm. Everything's the same. I'm thinking about pinching my elbow down to my butt, and I'm gonna twist, pull this heel into my chin, and I'm gonna hip into his knee. Again, we're here, we land here. I elbow the back pocket, I'm here. Whether I get my finish here or not, he can pull out or tap. Again, from here, immediately, right when he pulls out. Forehand, cross hand catches the heel. I'm smashing his top toes into my armpit. Now I'm violently pressing the armpit down, and I'm curling up and over. From here, I'm thinking about elbowing my butt while I pull this heel to my chin. That gives me my nasty rotation. I haven't even engaged my hips yet. It's nasty. I could get the finish from this. But once I twist it up and then hip in, that's when the compromisation of the deep. Makes sense? We have to center him on the captain. It's hard. See, if we have all our weight on this hip, it's hard to backstep. So we center him up, and now I kick out, and I'm in. And now from here, boom, I never lose position. I'm right to this finish, and when he lets go, boom, boom, boom.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm.